In this video, we're going to explain how to find the globular clusters contained within the Hercules constellation. The globular clusters are, of course, M13, the Great Globular Cluster, and M92. We will start with M92 because it's closest to our reference star. To find M92, locate Vega, the brightest star in the summer sky. From there, you want to head east towards the keystone part of the Hercules constellation. The stars that make up the keystone are roughly magnitude 3. Then, find the most northeastern star of the keystone, Pi Hercules, and head north. At this point, I'd recommend using a low-powered eyepiece to scan the sky until you see a small ball that's slightly fuzzy, and this will be M92. Higher magnification will show you that it's made up of multiple stars with a telescope of 6 inches aperture or more. Here is some live footage of M92 using a 5-second exposure. As you can see, it's made up of many stars, approximately 330,000 solar masses. This is in fact the brightest cluster in terms of absolute magnitude, and is 26,700 light years away from Earth. It is also one of the oldest globular clusters we know about. What is a globular cluster? If you imagine the galaxy as a disk, then globular clusters are like bees surrounding that galaxy, in fact in the galaxy's halo, which means it's still within the galaxy's sphere of influence. This next shot is a live stacked image of M92. I was taking 5-second exposures again, but stacking them on top of each other live to make a 70-second exposure overall. As you can see, this brings out many more stars than what you'd usually see with the naked eye. And it's very impressive. Next, we're going to find M13, the Great Globular Cluster. Again, start with the reference star Vega. Move across until you find a keystone, just like for M92. Find the two stars on the western side of the box, and go about halfway between them and slightly north. Here you should find M13. I'd recommend again using a low-powered eyepiece and scanning around a bit in case you're having issues. Then, once you've found it, go on to a higher power. As you can see, M13 is much more impressive than M92. A small telescope will show you a grainy texture to M13, while a telescope of 6 inches or more will show you the many stars it's composed of. M13 is the most impressive globular cluster in the Northern Hemisphere. However, it does in fact pale in comparison to Omega Centauri in the Southern Hemisphere. There's approximately 10 million stars. In this final scene, we're showing M13 again, this time using a 56-second live-stacked image. As you can see, this has brought up even more stars and looks even more spectacular than before. Well, that's it for this video. If you want to support us, please like this video, leave a comment, or subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much, and clear skies.